Welcome to a video tutorial on mammalian retina and photoreceptors. This tutorial was produced by Peixi Chen and Jerry Sher under the guidance of Drs. Takako Noguchi and Susan Golden. So, let's begin. The light is the primary time cue to adjust circadian rhythms of mammals. The light signal received by the retina aligns the internal body clock to the environment's light-dark cycle, regulating the patterns of activities and physiological functions inside the body. This process is known as photic entrainment. To understand photic entrainment, it is critical that we understand the photoreception system within mammalian eyes. In this video tutorial, we would like to introduce the anatomical features of the mammalian retina, photoreceptors, and the pathway through which the retina translates light information to the other regions of the brain. Although non-mammalian vertebrates have photosensitive organs outside of the eyes, such as the pineal gland in birds, a big body of studies show that their eyes are the only photosensitive organ to control vision in mammals. In mammals, the retina is located at the back of their eyes, where the light entered from the cornea is projected to. The retina senses the light through three types of photoreceptor cells: the rods, the cones, and the intrinsically photosensitive retinal ganglion cells, referred to as the IPRGCs. The retina processes light entering the eye and transmits the signal to the inner brain to produce graphic information of the environment. In other words, the retina helps us to see things. This function is called image-forming vision. However, the retina is also responsible for other functions that do not involve image formation. This function is called non-image-forming vision, pupillary constriction, which controls the amount of light entering the eye, as well as photic entrainment of circadian rhythms, are both types of non-image-forming functions. The rods and cones are mainly responsible for image-forming vision. They are located within the outermost layer of the retina. Rods are able to sense a small amount of light and are responsible for vision under dim light conditions. Cones are responsible for color perception. They contain photoreceptor proteins or photopigments that react to light, called rhodopsin and coneopsins. A disruption of rods and cones lead to the loss of image-forming vision, hence the loss of graphic information from the environment. However, mammals without rods and cones can still manifest pupillary constriction and photic entrainment. So how can mammals still perform these non-image-forming functions without rods and cones? This is because the third photoreceptor cells, the IPRGCs, which are responsible for non-image-forming functions, are still intact. IPRGCs reside in the innermost layer of the retina. They are a small subset of retinal ganglion cells that express a photopigment called melanopsin. This photopigment responds to light, allowing IPRGCs to become photosensitive. In addition, when only IPRGCs are ablated or destroyed, it results in the near-complete loss of non-image-forming functions, while leaving the image-forming functions intact. However, the IPRGCs are not the only photoreceptors responsible for non-image-forming vision. Rods and cones also contribute. Studies show that even after knocking out the gene called OPN4M, which encodes melanopsin, non-image-forming functions do not completely disappear. However, knocking out rods and cones in addition to melanopsin results in complete loss of non-image-forming function, as well as image-forming function in mammalian models. Therefore, IPRGCs are not only responsible for receiving light signals directly, but also for transferring non-image-forming information that was initiated by rods and cones to the downstream targets of the brain. How exactly are light signals conveyed to the regions of the brain controlling image-forming and non-image-forming vision? Rods, cones, and IPRGCs are sensitive to different wavelengths of light. After light signals are received by rods and cones, the signals are relayed to retinal ganglion cells, including IPRGCs, through the intermediate layer, and then to the inner brain. At the same time, IPRGCs alone are able to directly receive light signals by melanopsin. Retinal ganglion cells then send their bundled axons or optic nerves to the optic chiasma, where left and right optic nerves cross. Here, part of IPRGCs directly innervate the suprachiasmatic nucleus referred to as the SCN in the hypothalamus, the master circadian center that is located on top of the optic chiasma. Past the optic chiasma, axons of retinal ganglion cells and other IPRGCs extend further and project to the contralateral or the other side of the brain to reach the lateral geniculate nucleus in the thalamus. Here, light information is relayed to neurons that project to the visual cortex, the part of the brain that is responsible for image formation. Retinal ganglion cells and IPRGCs innervate the other brain regions, too. As it interprets the information from the retina, the SCN is adjusted to environmental light-dark cycles, and in turn, either directly or indirectly coordinates the peripheral clocks that reside in almost all tissues and organs of the mammalian body. Mammals can anticipate the environmental cycles of the day and optimize their behavior and physiologies. We conclude our tutorial on mammalian retina and photoreceptors. Thank you for watching. We hope you found this video informative and educational.